All right, everyone, welcome back to me coughing. Welcome back to round one here. This is our blue-white-black aggro whispering madness deck. We're not going to mulligan the sand. We have a couple of Delvers, a bounce spell, all of our mana, two bounce spells, actually. So this is the type of hand where it doesn't really matter that we have this little combo in our deck. We're just going to beat down because we have a beatdown deck. If we, you know, play the all-in Niv-Magus Elemental version, we could very easily end up losing here because all this stuff would be irrelevant combo pieces. You might not even be able to keep this hand, to be honest. All right, so we're just going to tempo them out a lot. We have three bounce spells, still two Lingering Souls, so if we draw a land, we get to cast those. If we don't draw a land, there's a good chance we're flipping this. Probably just going to bounce that. Nope. So yeah, I think I'm just going to bounce that and then cast Lingering Souls next turn. Or maybe even cast this again on an extra, I don't know. We'll see what we draw. We have on a pretty nice clock here, so time walking him, in a sense, is not bad. Alright, so he's just going to play that again. Yes, we'll flip this guy. So now we have a two-turn clock with these or these, so I'm going to go ahead and play Lingering Souls. He's got to have a Wrath, which he might. But even if he does, we're not out of it. And this way, if he kills a Delver, we have lethal. And if he kills, obviously, if he kills a Spirit or both Spirits, we have lethal. So he's got to kill two to three threats, depending on what he can kill. All right, so he's got Backdoor Wrath of God. Yeah, I'm just going to play this. We don't have anything else we want to play this turn, so I don't mind using that half because it saves us a little bit of mana. Like, if I had a Thought Scour that turn, obviously I would have just flashbacked the other thing. Alright, so that is gross. How do I win this game? I don't know how we're gonna win this game. I think I just play Sin Collector and let him die. Alright, we get a Temporal Mastery, Ranger's Path, I don't care about that, we're gonna take this. Alright, so he's kind of playing the ramp deck that I've been tinkering with for a long time. A little bit different, but Temporal Mastery ramp is really sweet with Chandra. I never played Curse in it, but it is working for him here, so. I actually don't even know how we can win the game. Might just scoop some. I have to basically bounce this and then whispers it away, which is obviously not where you want to be right now. If I could set up a Cyclonic Rift into Whispers, that'll be pretty good. Like a kicked Cyclonic Rift. So for the full 7 mana. Yeah, he's just putting a million lands into play. He's going to set up for Omniscience, I assume. if you guys haven't seen that yet, you'll get a chance to see how it all works. He's not necessarily that deck, but more than likely. Alright, we're just drawing useless cards. We basically just want to be drawing lands right now. We don't have anything that could live through this card. Now we're just getting pinged. What does that do for us? We could Thought Cast or Thought Scour. I might do that if we have to. Draw another Ranger's Path, maybe. Yep. Just gonna have six. I think we're safe here. He's got no cards in hand. Yeah, we're fine. He's got all this mana. He's got nothing to do with it yet. All right, a land. I'll take it. Like, what we're gonna try to do, we have to draw lands and we have to draw whispers. And then bounce all his stuff and whispers it away. All right, there's that. He's got a Chandra ticking up. She's only at two. We're fine. Right, so right now, if we do bounce, everything is four. He can't. Any creature's lethal. That kind of sucks. We're just like dead in so many ways here. I mean, our hand's actually pretty good at staying alive. If he draws some type of fireball effect, we're dead. Basically what it comes down to, and we have no way to prevent that. We have a bunch of duresses in our deck and sin collectors, but that's not going to stop a top deck, lethal whatever. Ideally, I need to get to 8 mana, draw Notion Thief and Whispers, so I could set up the full blowouts. Because otherwise, I don't know, the game's gonna be rough. Because even if I just bounce and whispers, he's still going to have a hand of four cards that could very easily beat me. With Notion Thief, though, that'll put him away. Going to miss a land drop here. I'm going to go ahead and Thought Scour. Going to mill him. Reason being is I have nothing I want to get in the graveyard at this point. Lingering Souls and Silent Departure don't really do anything. And it could come down to a decking game, I'm not sure. Alright, do I have to discard? I do. Is that four? What's it start with normally? Is there any way to know? I wish I knew what to start with. I think it's three. Maybe I should just discard here and not care. Or is there something I can. He has one card in hand, it's likely a land. I think I'm just gonna duress him here. Maybe I shouldn't. He didn't do anything with it. I should just bounce his Chandra and make him replay it. It's better than just discarding a card for no value. I can't do anything with this out of the yard anyway. You can't overload it out of the graveyard. We need lands. We chew all the cards we don't need. Like, we need lands, we need Notion Thieves, we need Whispering Madness. And we've drawn Farways and Lingering Souls. We're beating him down pretty hard, too. He's at five life. We just have no way to. This is not good. Whatever it is, it's not good. Alright. Could have bounced it there, but I'd rather just make him sacrifice it, so. All right, we drew a land. Far and away doesn't do anything, so I'm just gonna cast away. I guess I wait till this combat step. Cause I probably dump a bunch of mana into it. Not that it matters all that much, but I have so many copies of this card that it's not like he's gonna be able to counter them all or anything like that. If he goes to Chandra me. Before combat, I'll go ahead and cast it, but otherwise, I might get a bunch of mana out of him with the Keswick Wolf Run. Waiting on him to do something. The good news is also we have enough mana to overload our Cyclonic Rift, but like I said, alright, restriction, go ahead and cast away. So we'll take one, we're at eight. Not a great place to be, but alive. Sin Collector. Yeah, I'm fine casting that. Putrefy and a Terminus. Do we care about either of these cards? I guess he could putrefy my Notion Thief, so that's the scary one. Terminus is sorcery speed, so it won't matter. I have one more Cyclonic Rift to reset this before I need it for my full combo thingy. Still need a land, an Ocean Thief, and a Whispering Madness. Come on, deck, deliver! Yeah, I hate you too. This goes off at 6, so I need to do this now, probably. Do it during his upkeep, I guess. I guess I'm fine with him losing it. It puts me at 1. It means if he draws another Chandra, I'm dead. Chances are he's going to plus 1 to this turn, though. Yeah, alright. Pick him up, pick him up. He could just recast it all one turn, but uses up his mana at least. He's got a Terminus in hand. All those things. So, if I flashback Lingering Soul, does that do anything for me? No. Pretty much need to draw. Yeah. Got my land, so I just need to draw 2 cards. They're both 4-0s. We're still behind the 8-ball here. Like, he's going to drop us to 5. We have to get him before the Chandra can kill us, is the big thing. We have enough stuff to keep creatures from killing us. I don't think he has any direct burn spells outside of the Chandra. So, if we draw those things, we should be able to win the game. And we're going to need them soon, next 2 to 3 draw steps. Goodness is we haven't drawn either of them, so we have 4 of each in our deck. So we're at like 12.5% chance to draw either one. Or we could draw that card. Again, one of the worst in our deck. What is this? Sphinx's Revelation. Well, if we had a Notion Thief right now, we might be able to win the game. But, oh no, we couldn't, because he's got the stupid curse. Oh no, he doesn't have curse out. Damn it. Alright, so we're probably dead. Be my guess. That thing's at 5. So after next turn, I have to bounce it. So I have to, like, draw one of the 2 pieces this turn. So the way Far and Away works, he will not have to sacrifice the beast because his thing won't trigger in between the 2 cards. It's considered one spell, but I can still Silent Departure it or whatever. Yeah, that's not what I want. Yeah, I'm just gonna do this, I think. I have to bounce his stuff. Maybe I can't do this. I have to bounce this stuff this turn. So, yeah, if I bounce this now, then bounce it, that'll be fine. Or I can just wait, actually. Bounce this second means that won't be good. Alright. Oh, he's also got this thing out. So, yeah, I almost have to do this. Okay, let's... He'll flash that thing back down. We're in a rough spot, obviously. Basically have to draw Whispering Madness. Alright, I guess fine. Yep. Could have countered that guy, but I think that's fine. So he's got a beast that can't attack, so I'm not really worried about it in terms of the wolf run. Alright, he's going to spend those. He didn't even play the refuge. He tapped the refuge even, which is good for us. He's spending his mana on those things. I'm sure the Thrag Tusk will come back down. Yep. Don't play the curse. Alright, play the tree. Tree is certainly annoying. And we drew duress! It's not what we want. Alright, I think this game is over. I mean, I guess I can maybe play out of this. I don't think so, though. I could have bounced duress. That would have been good. Forgot that duress takes planeswalkers. Let's bounce. Interesting. Alright. So here we'll go ahead and bounce and counter. Because we got nothing else we can really do. And then he'll have a 3-3 and we'll have a far one way to deal with it. At 5? Jeez. Not that matters. I guess 2 activations were dead regardless. Plays land. Oh, is he going to play the Thrag Tusk now? Nice. He could have done it instant speed. And I wouldn't be able to get it for... Oh no, he's playing that card. Could have played that instant speed too, I guess. I could have duressed his curse, I suppose. But he hadn't played it the last 30 turns that he had the mana available. So I guess I wasn't really expecting him to. Yeah, we're just dead. Basically, if we didn't get that combination of cards, none of our plays, regardless of how incorrect or correct they were going to be, were going to work. What are we boarding here? I guess he has a lot of these things, but I don't think enough to warrant both of these cards. I have really no way to deal with the curse, though. That's the big problem, except for these dresses. Yeah, I don't see it getting any better. None of this stuff's super exciting against him. This locks down a Planeswalker, I suppose. Essence Scatter isn't great against him, but I don't. Maybe. Bring him. All my stuff's one toughness. This sucks. I wish I had negates and not dispel. But what are you gonna do? I could do like he had putrefy. No, that's not good. I don't mind bringing in one of these guys, though. Sure, I'll bring in one of each of those. I have no idea. This matchup's not gonna be great regardless, I don't think, but I'm gonna try this out. Woo!